I have the privilege of sharing just a few words, and I must let you know that my respect for the decision that you have made to be in this auditorium today and through this weekend is beyond measure. And I'll explain that in a moment. First, I get the topic of explaining and sharing with you about chasing bigger dreams. Now, we've been hearing about dreams all morning, haven't we? And the Amelia said, will you dare to dream? And that others dared to dream. And you saw examples of people who dared to dream. And I get to talk about chasing bigger dreams. But I would say that my talk isn't just about chasing bigger dreams as much as it is about capturing bigger dreams and pulling them into you so they become reality for you and your family. And I want to start with a story that I heard from my good friend Ignacio Villa about a young boy he discovered that was so excited about life. I mean, this young man on the playground would enthusiastically tell all of his friends about the great plans he had for his life, the things he would do, the places he would go, traveling around the world, the great leaders he would meet and talk with. Oh, he talked about the fun that he would have. A sparkle would be in his eyes as he shared with his friends these great things that he had planned for his life. And like most young boys, so filled with optimism and excitement. And the teacher who was helping this young man out had become a little concerned at this boy's excitement. And this teacher looked back on his own life, remembering only disappointment, remembering obstacles, failures, challenges that he had faced in his life. And he decided to himself, you know, I'm going to go ahead and talk with this young man and help him out, maybe as to soften his fall. And he approaches the young boy on the playground and says, young man, walk with me a while. And takes him along a road. And with all the love in his heart, the sincerity in his heart, and with the very best of intentions, said, young man, this life you speak of is not for people like you and people like me. This life of excitement that you talk about is not for us. You see, you'll find, boy, that life is very hard, very difficult, and it is very challenging. In fact, boy, until you reach the age of 30, you will find that it's so extremely difficult, filled with frustration, and even it's unfair. Unfulfillment will reach you. Yes, sometimes it's spotted with despair. Moments of joy will be scattered within these moments, but it's tough, it's hard. And see, you'll graduate high school one day. Soon, you'll be off, and to college you may go. But when you graduate, you'll be in debt. You'll get a job you may like at first, excited to be in the real world. You'll go venture out, get some loans and credit cards, numbers on the bottom that aren't your friend, little pieces of plastic. Said you may get married, you may have children. And as the years slip by, you'll realize that the rent, the debt, the credit card bills, and the other obligations will hang around your neck like a chain. Like a harness strapped to your back as you plow another man's field. Now, you'll be blinded to this because you won't really understand what's going on. You know all the things that get in the way of life, the distractions. This dream that you once spoke of and that you've been speaking of to your classmates will begin to fade. Yes, boy, until 30, life is going to be very challenging. In fact, you're going to struggle almost every day and every week and every month. You're going to cry. Maybe there'll be times when you don't have enough food to eat. When you can't pay your bills. You'll live in a place you may not want to live, wear clothing that you don't want to wear. You'll eat food that's maybe not the best for you and for your family. Yes, boy, life will be very challenging at times. Until you reach 30, life will hurt. So now, this boy starting to tear up. He was once excited, once happy, just a moment ago with his young friends. Starts to get teary, and he says, listen, you're going to be distracted, and these dreams will fade. He says, well, teacher, what will happen when I reach the age of 30? A little bit of hope in his voice at this point. The teacher just sighs. At 30, son, you're going to get used to it. How many of us does this describe? How many of us have just settled? Ladies and gentlemen, according to the Social Security Administration, after following 100 working adults through their life, they found that 95% at the age 65 are financially dependent on friends, family, or the federal government. Just for the basics, just for food, clothing, and shelter. Think about that, 95%. So is our fate, much like that boy's, settling? Well, according to the Social Security Administration, it certainly appears so. Only 5% will become financially independent. 1% wealthy. Now, if you had a choice between the 95 and the 5, which would you choose? Let me just ask that one more time. If you had a choice between the 95 and the 5, which would you choose? I would imagine you spend a lot of money and time and sacrifice to be here today, to learn to be a part of that 5, to be a part of that 5, and I would say even further than that, to be a part of that 1%. So is our fate that of the little boy? Say, no, not me. See, I think not. I think not. You see, today, my friends, we draw a line in the sand. We draw a line in the sand for our families, for our community, for ourselves, for our God. Today, we draw a line in the sand. And this is exciting. I mean, this is exciting stuff. You know why? Because there's a formula. See, I didn't know it before. There's a formula to get from 95 to 5. Isn't that interesting? See, before when I was growing up, I didn't know. I didn't understand. I didn't know that there was a road, a journey, where I could go from 95 to 5. In fact, I didn't even know I was in the 95%. I didn't know it. I was blinded. Blinded. Because life gets in the way. There is a formula. And I'm excited. Because, see, I think, and you and I both agree, I would imagine that the cemetery is filled with unrealized dreams. People who lack the courage to dare to dream, let alone dream on their own. Songs buried that were never sung. Music that was composed that will never be heard. But I say not you. I say not you. I say today is the day we draw the line in the sand because there's a formula. There is a solution for you. There's a solution for me. Now, check this out. This is cool. I learned this from my great friend and one of my mentors, Mr. Frank Acoin, Ms. Teresa Acoin. And I didn't realize, and I'd gone through this and they pointed it out, there's four parts. There's four parts that are vital, and I would say even critical, you and I need to change in order to go from 95 to 5. Now, what are these four? Do you want to know? Yeah. I mean, I wanted to know. Four parts to change. Four parts to change. It's all we need. The journey that you're about to embark upon is not for the faint of heart. I must warn you. Right? Disclaimer, disclaimer. Are there people with courage in the room? This journey, there's three things required to go on this journey to get these four parts right. The first is a burning desire. Who has a burning desire? You see, it's white hot. You can see it in some people. I mean, they got it glowing in their eyes, right? Second part, a willingness to learn. A willingness to learn and be coachable. Third part, a willingness to work. See, some of us have the burning desire. We even have the willingness to learn. We're coachable. We show up at the briefings, but we don't do anything in between the briefings. Right? Show up at the briefing, do nothing, show up at the training. Woohoo! Show up at the briefing, do nothing, show up at the training. Woohoo! And see, this is not the time to do that. See, by participating in this, you draw the line in the sand. This is an important factor. See, there's these four things. So if you're ready, say I'm ready.